Hyper Light Drifter is a game I waited far too long to play. I bought it at the start of the year, having been drawn in by its colorful aesthetic and the general praise it was receiving, but I just never really got around to it until recently. It follows the journey of the titular Drifter as they explore a vast world to find and activate all the shards and monuments needed to open up the abyss and face the monstrosity lurking inside. It's a game with a small but detailed world, fun gameplay, and what stuck with me the most as I played it, a trippy sense of surreality. And today, I want to talk about why this makes Hyper Light Drifter so fun to play. And yes, potential spoilers ahead. From the moment the game starts, its artwork sets up a dreamlike landscape of color and vibrancy. We're shown an introductory cutscene with a cacophony of bright and surreal imagery. From the giant purple halo that floats in the sky as a massive explosion engulfs the landscape, to the Drifter running up a short flight of stairs to face off against three gargantuan colossi, screaming into the void, only for them to slowly fall apart. When we reach the game proper, we see its distinct neon color palette full of bright greens and blues and soft hues of purple and red, mixed together with more natural tones. It feels unreal. As if the colors we see here are simply too strong or bright to exist so naturally alongside everything else. This is emphasized by the multitude of trippy set pieces we run into in our adventure, such as the many corpses of the colossal giants from earlier, which now littered the landscape. The game's artwork and unique color palette gives it a dreamlike quality that draws attention to its more fantastical elements. And it's important to pay attention to those details, as there's no dialogue. The game has set up to rely on visuals alone to build its narrative. The few cutscenes that are in the game are packed to the brim with symbolic meaning. The many NPCs you run into throughout the game recount their experiences through pictures, which are cleverly designed to give us a clear understanding of what they've gone through and what dangers may be waiting for us on our journey. The environment is filled with small details that paint a specific picture of this world, from the bloody corpses strung up on poles beside abandoned camps in the east, to the giant pink test tubes filled with all sorts of fascinating abominations in the dungeons of the south. Even the giants' varied states of death give us an insight into this world. Specifically, what these giants were like, how the inhabitants of this world dealt with them, and later, how they used them. The only direct communication the player gets is in the tutorial and when unlocking a new warp area. The game's use of visual storytelling is a clever feat of creativity that keeps the player wondering about what kind of world they've wandered into as they run into more and more pieces of its puzzle. This idea of letting the player explore and take the time to think things through bleeds into the gameplay as well. It encourages the player to investigate every little nook and cranny of the map to find all of its hidden secrets, and even a good few collectibles, like the modules and the extra shards. And though the combat is fun, fast, and dynamic, encouraging the player to combine their sword attacks, gunshots, and dashes to fight, the many scenarios it throws the player into require you to stop and think about what you're doing. You'll more often than not die over and over and over again until you develop the perfect strategy for an area. This is amplified by the game's variety of enemies and the way it mixes and matches them, forcing the player to switch between playstyles to deal with each of their unique fighting patterns. Hyper Light Drifter's gameplay encourages the player to take the time to both fully explore its world and to create strategies to fight your way through it. But for as much as I enjoy it, I do have a few nitpicks. The boss fights are jarringly difficult compared to the rest of the game, but are admittedly easy to deal with once you figure them out. Except for this motherfucker, but still. The music, though beautifully atmospheric, gets ear-piercingly loud at times, specifically in these scenes, to the point that it genuinely hurt, even at a quarter volume. And there are a few glitches. Most of them are harmless, like this floating squirrel or phasing through this one wall in the southern region, but there was one I encountered I think is worth pointing out. I got stuck outside a door, and when I tried to open it, it flat out killed me. It happened in the southern region in the dungeons at different locations. Luckily, I respawned right outside the glitch door and still had all the progress I'd made, which I was especially thankful for since the first time it happened, it was just after the boss fight with this motherfucker. And I think it's something to point out in case you aren't lucky and it doesn't save. But outside of that, and a bit of lag on my lower-end laptop, I had very few problems with this game. Overall, Hyper Light Drifter is a surreal and trippy game with a focus on careful exploration and strategic combat. With fluid, responsive controls, awe-inspiring imagery, and a detailed world full of hidden secrets, it's an experience that kept me in its loop for hours on end, and one that I still play. Though I've already beaten it twice, there's still a lot in this game to dive into, such as the mini-games in the town, collecting all the collectibles, diving into the lore, trying out the boss rush mode, and more. It's a game that keeps me coming back. And that's what makes it so fun to play. And yeah, those are my thoughts. Tell me what you think. If you agree, disagree, what kind of art styles you like in games, if you're a fan of Hyper Light Drifter, etc. And thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this and want to see more, check out my last video where I break down Resident Evil 7's masterfully crafted atmosphere. Or check out my video on The Punisher and why its grittier tone makes it so fun to watch. And don't forget to like, comment, share, and of course, subscribe to come fly with me. And hopefully, I'll see you later.